leading the way, changing the game, your boy S.A. Taking to the radio way, the issues that we face today. He ain't afraid to speak his mind, to make a change in people's lives. If you ain't motivated, keep it locked to get it popping. If you need inspiration, turn it up when Sean starts talking.
Welcome to another edition of Flow of Wisdom Radio. I'm your host, Sean Anthony. Definitely appreciate you taking the time to tune in. I have quite a bit of information I want to share with you. So, you know, I'll try to get through most of it. And then towards the end, maybe the last 10 minutes or so, I'll open it up for phone calls, questions, or comments. And today's topic is the MK Ultra mind control and the Connecticut shooting. First of all, let me just say this. When I first heard that news, it was just saddening, and just I'm sure like all of Americans are touched by that. Well, I would say most Americans are touched by that. I mean, any person that does harm to children, I have a problem with that. I have a problem when you mess with innocent kids. Hosea, the prophet Hosea, in chapter 4, verse 6, I'll lead off with this. He says, "My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because you have rejected knowledge, I also will reject you from being priests for me. Because you have forgotten the law of your God, I also will forget your children. If more people knew the truth of at least half the things that our government is doing, it would truly be an outcry and a demand for change." With all that being said, I want to share some knowledge with you, some information, because a lot of people are not privy to certain things. Aside from the Connecticut shooting, I just want to let you know that there's things that are in place. The movie Manchurian Candidate, starring Denzel Washington. And first of all, Manchurian Candidate is an unwitting assassin, brainwashed and programmed to kill. A Manchurian Candidate is an unwitting assassin, brainwashed and programmed to kill. According to Wired.com, in an article published in January of 2009, for two decades or more during the Cold War, the CIA and the military allegedly plied the unwitting with acid, weed, and dozens of psychoactive drugs in a series of zany and sometimes dangerous mind control experiments. Now, the Vietnam Veterans of America are suing the agency and the Pentagon for perceived abuses suffered under the so-called MK Ultra and other projects. Six veterans are suffering from all kinds of ailments tied to this diabolical and secret testing program, according to a statement from the veterans' lawyers passed on to Spy Talk's Jeff Stein. The experiments allegedly include the use of troops to test nerve gas, psychochemicals, and thousands of other toxic chemicals and biological substances, and the insertion of septal implants in the brains of subjects in mind control experiments that went awry, leaving many civilian and military subjects with permanent disabilities, end quote. Subjects were tested without their consent, the veteran said. And when the trials were over, the government failed to provide health care or compensation. Here's a declassified CIA document dated back January 7th of 1953. It describes the creation of multiple personalities in 19-year-old girls. These subjects have clearly demonstrated that they can pass from a fully awake state to a deep hypnotic controlled state by telephone, by receiving written matter, or by use of code, signal, or words, and that control of those hypnotized can be passed from one individual to another without great difficulty. It has also been shown by experimentation with these girls that they can act as unwilling character couriers for information purposes. A few days ago, right before the Connecticut shooting, I was up late night watching, I think it was True TV or Discovery Channel, one of those TV stations. And this particular program where they were showing how this man, they had this guy who was a prison guard. He was a corrections officer. He worked in a penitentiary. And they gave his characteristic traits, said this guy was a good American citizen. He was well-mannered. He was, I think it was a former military. And he was just, all his characteristic traits were of a good person, good-hearted person. And they showed how they hypnotized this guy. And they told him when he was hypnotized, when he fell under hypnosis, they said, when you wake up, you're going to walk out of this building, you're going to shake the hand of this particular person, and he's going to tell you, congratulations, you did a great job, or something like that. It was some sort of phrase, and he shook his hand. He said, he's going to shake your hand like this, and he gave an example of how the man was going to shake his hand. And he said, when you hear this phrase, you're going to look for a red bag, and inside this bag, there's going to be a gun. And when you get this gun, we want you to pull it out, and we want you to shoot so-and-so, this politician or whoever this person was. Now, all of this was staged, okay? The gun was filled with blank bullets, and the so-called target had that Hollywood fake blood type stuff, you know, on it, so that when the guy pulled the trigger, that, you know, it looked like he got shot for real. All of this was staged. So the guy, you know, wakes up from the hypnosis, walks outside the building. The man approaches him, shakes his hand and gives that statement. He sees the red bag, pulls out the gun. The target walks out and he starts shooting. And afterwards, they pulled him back in and they woke him up out of the hypnosis. And they asked him, you know, do you remember what happened? The guy had no recollection of what he did. He had no memory whatsoever what he did. Then they showed him the videotape of what he carried out. And as the guy is watching this videotape of him doing this heinous act, mind you, it was all staged. The guy started to watch his body language. He started getting agitated. And they started asking him, you know, how do you feel about this? He's like, I'm mad. I'm a little upset that you guys did this to me, and I had no control or no idea. I don't remember any of this. He had no clue. So they asked him, Do you want us to bring back your memory? And he's like, yeah. So he hypnotized the guy, put him back on hypnosis, and he told him, when you wake up, you're gonna remember everything. Wakes up, he remembered everything. And mind you, they aired this a couple of days prior to the Connecticut shooting. Now, it goes to show you that there is clearly an agenda set, and this stuff is real. Now, whether you want to believe it or not, the facts are facts. It's documented, ladies and gentlemen. They're doing these type of things. And it's so sad that they would use innocent children. And I'm not saying this whole Connecticut thing is a CI op or, you know, but I'm telling you, it smells fishy to me. It smells fishy to me. I can only go by what I know. And once you become privy to certain information, once you are aware of certain things, it's really difficult for you to look at certain acts that take place or events that take place at face value. Once you become privy to certain information, and I'm sharing this with you all because I believe that we all need to start becoming aware of what's really going on out there. And like I said at the beginning of the show, if more people knew what things have been done and what things are underway, I believe that more Americans would speak up about it. But see, it's designed to create distractions. You know, other people in other countries are mocking us, Americans. They're mocking us how distracted we are. We're distracted by fast foods. We're distracted by our favorite reality shows. We're distracted by the NFL and football. We're distracted by, the X Factor. I mean, you name it. There's so many distractions set place for Americans. The masses are so unaware of all of these things that's going on. And look, as I said in the beginning, My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Why do you think that they are trying to shut down the internet? Why do you think that they're trying to charge us and have us pay to use the internet? Because there's so much information flowing right now, they can't control it. They can't control it. So, you know, with all that being said, it's time to take a stand. Look, here's the thing. We are in a serious season right now. And things like this in Connecticut and Portland and the Colorado shooting, there's going to be more events, staged events that's going to take place. And it's going to cost some people some lives. But we're in a season now where we have to be better prepared for our family and our friends. One of the main areas investigated by the CIA was mind control. Now, the behavioral program, control program, was motivated by Soviet, Chinese, and North Korean use of mind control techniques. The CIA originated its first program in 1950 under the name Bluebird. MK Ultra officially began in 1953. Now, in 1973, tipped off about forthcoming investigations, the CIA director Richard Helms ordered the destruction of any MK Ultra records. Now, the Senate intelligence community did find some records during this its investigation in 1976. Senator Frank Church, who led the congressional investigations of the CIA unlawful action, said that the agency was a quote unquote rogue elephant operating above the law as it plotted assassinations, illegally spied on thousands of Americans, and even drugged citizens in its effort to develop new weapons for its covert arsenal. In 1977, through a Freedom of Information Act request, 16,000 pages of mind control documents were found as part of the agency's financial history. And that is how this information has been pieced together. Look, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going through articles, declassified documentation from the CIA, and old articles in the media, just for the simple fact letting you know that these are facts of this type of technology, this type of mind altering behavioral things. It's real, because some people think that, you know, when you mention certain things, oh, you know, this mass shooter in Colorado, it's mind control, the situation in Portland, Oregon, the thing that happened at the not the mosque, but the one of the religious things in the Midwest, I'm sorry. And even the situation that just happened here in Connecticut, when you hear certain people saying certain things, you know, that, man, this could be an inside job, a false flag, you know, all with an agenda predicated to implement gun laws. But I'll get to all of that other stuff in a minute. But nonetheless, I just want to give y'all facts. So, and this show is being recorded, so it's documented. You know, you could take it back, share it with others or whatever. Just getting this information out is the most important thing right now, so you can share it with others. Anyway, a CIA document dated back February the 10th, 1954, describes an experiment on the creation of unsuspecting assassins. Quote, Miss Blank was then instructed, having expressed a fear of firearms, that she would use every method at her disposal to awaken Miss Blank. Now in a deep hypnotic sleep, and failing this, she would pick up a pistol and fire it at Miss Blank. She was instructed that she would not hesitate to quote unquote kill Miss Blank, carried out these suggestions, including firing the unloaded gun at Blank. After proper suggestions were made, both were awakened. Miss Blank expressed absolute denial that the foregoing sequence had happened, end quote. Now, mind you, that was a CIA document that I'm quoting. Everything I'm quoting to you guys, I'm giving you the references, so you can go and fact check, if you will. So like when you go to church and you hear the preacher preaching a message and he gives you Bible scriptures, I don't know about you, but I'll go home and I'll get those scriptures and read the truth for myself. So that I'm sharing all of these references for you. Anyway, the CIA data show 14-year-old project on controlling human behavior. This is an article that was published in July 1977 in the New York Times. It says the Central Intelligence Agency conducted a 14-year program to find ways to, quote unquote, control human behavior through the use of chemical, biological, and radiological material. According to agency documents made public today by John Marks, the documents suggested broader experimentation on unwitting means just oblivious, not knowing, humans by the intelligence agency or its paid researchers that have been publicly known before. Mr. Marks distributed 20 documents that describe the following incidents, among others. In 1956, the CIA contracted with a private physician to test a drug that can cause stupor or induce a catatonic state. A letter from an unnamed CIA official in 1949 discusses ways of killing people without leaving a trace. Quote, I believe there are two chemical substances which would be most useful in that they would have no characteristic pathological findings, end quote. And now in 1952, two Russian agents were interrogated using sodium pentothal and a stimulant. One interrogation produced a remarkable regression, the paper said, during which the subject actually relived certain past activities of his life. Look, it's documented that they are doing this type of mind altering experiments on humans. I mean, hell, like, think back what they did on the Tuskegee era. The Tuskegee experiment, what they did with those men. Here's another article in Time magazine that was published in 2002, Human Guinea Pigs at Your Own Risk. Over the past 3 years, more than 60 institutions, including several of the world's most prestigious research centers, have been criticized by the U.S. government for failing to protect human subjects adequately. As recently as 1974, individual scientists and their financial backers could decide for themselves what constituted ethical research. Most of the time, their judgment was sound, but there are plenty of appalling exceptions. In the 1950s, Army doctors gave LSD to soldiers without telling them what it was. In 1963, researchers injected prisoners and terminally ill patients with live cancer cells to test their immune responses. They were told only that it was a skin test. Next time you go to the doctors and the doctor suggests, let's take a skin test, you may want to think twice or question that doctor. In the 1950s, mentally retarded children at Willowbrook, a state institution in New York, were deliberately infected with hepatitis so that scientists could work on experimental vaccine. And in perhaps the most infamous cases on record, doctors at Georgia's Tuskegee Institution, starting in the 1930s, deliberately withheld treatment from syphilis-infected African-American men for 40 years to monitor the course of the disease. Financial conflicts of interest can extend not only to the institutions, but also to the researchers themselves. Sidney Gottlieb, that's the name that you should remember, because he was the one that took LSD to the CIA. And an article in the New York Times back in 1999 that was published, Sidney Gottlieb, who presided over the Central Intelligence Agency's Cold War efforts to control the human mind and provided the agency poisons to kill Fidel Castro, died on Sunday. He spent his later years caring for dying patients and fighting lawsuits from survivors of his secret tests. He would always be remembered as the government chemist who dosed Americans with psychedelics in the name of national security. So you wonder how LSD came into place back in the 60s and the 70s. Well, that was the man, that scientist, Sidney Gottlieb. Look up his name, Gottlieb. It says Mr. Gottlieb was fascinated by the drug and it took it hundreds of times. In the 1950s and early 60s, the agency gave mind-altering drugs to hundreds of unsuspecting Americans in an effort to explore the possibilities of controlling human consciousness. In one case, a mental patient in Kentucky was dosed with LSD continuously for 174 days. That's crazy. Other experiments involved agency employees, military officers, and college students. In all, the agency conducted 149 separate mind control experiments. As many as 25 involved unwitting subjects, just not knowing. At least one participant died, others went mad, and still others suffered psychological damage after participating in the project known as MKUltra. MKUltra. Now, I'm sharing all of that to share with you guys to begin to think and question certain things. For example, let's go to the Colorado shooter, the Batman shooter. Someone hit me on Facebook and asked me, yo, whatever happened to the dude that did the Batman shooting? You know, I said probably in a lab somewhere being tested on, you know. And just think for a moment. Remember the coverage of the Batman shooter? When he was in court, his eyes, his body language and characteristics, it appeared to me like he was on something. That guy did not have a clear mind, a state of conscience. He didn't look coherent whatsoever, in my opinion. Okay, now think about this. How can someone be that incoherent where their pupils are dilated, but yet in police custody? Think about it. Think about it. If he was in police custody and detained, you know, in handcuffs, even if he was, you know, high on something when he took the shootings, I mean, wouldn't you think that would have wore off? Or unless it was something that was induced in him, like an LSD, and I'm just throwing hypothetical situations out there. LSD, from my understanding, you stay stoned for like, what, 8 hours or something like that? I don't know. But to me, it looks like that guy was on something. And how can you be on something if he's in police custody or the federal agent's custody? It's just some things I think you got to question. And you look at the characteristics that the people that knew him said he was smart, he was bright. They would never expect that. The same thing with the situation in Portland, the Portland shooter that happened a few days early last week. This guy opens up fire in the Portland Mall, 22 years old. Jake, I'm quoting from the NewYorkDailyNews.com. Jake was never the violent type, Robert's ex-girlfriend told ABC News. His main goal was to make you laugh, smile, and make you feel uncomfortable, she said. But anyway, people were coming out speaking, saying this was not like him. I even seen the interviews that they did on CNN about this guy in Portland, and everybody that spoke about the kid's character, they said he was a good kid. He was, you know, not the type that would open up fire on anyone. Now, the aunt, moving to Connecticut, the aunt of the alleged shooter in the Connecticut shooting, the aunt speaks out and says it was just an actually, this is the neighbor saying it was just a nice, normal family. All of these guns that were confiscated from Adam, the kid that did the shooting in Connecticut, was registered to his mother. All the weapons were registered to his mother. Now, I got a message, and I just caught it like maybe an hour or so before I became live. Someone said that, and mind you, I have not fact checked this yet, what I'm about to share with you, but someone told me that the elementary school teacher's mom was ex-CIA, was an ex-CIA. Now, I tried to fact check it prior to coming on live doing this show, but I didn't find anything yet. But I find that interesting, you know, if that is true, that his mother was ex-CIA. Nonetheless, this mother had all of these guns, and one of the neighbors said that she would go target shooting with her boys pretty often. You know, it's just crazy. But nonetheless, some of the neighbors and the aunts that lived in the neighborhood in Connecticut just spoke very I would say highly of the kid, said that, you know, he was a very smart kid. He was, you know, they were a loving family, that nothing was out of the ordinary. And I just find it strange that these people that are doing these mass killings, the character witnesses, if you will, or character people to testify on the person's character. Wait a minute, I'm getting a tweet right now from somebody. What does it say? It said, can't verify if mother at this point, but alleged shooter's father is connected to GE and the LIBOR scandal. Wow. That's from Cliff Solo on Twitter. Thank you, man. Here's something else I want to add. The drone strikes that American, United States government, our military, has been killing a lot of innocent children and women. This is an article that came out back in September in the Los Angeles Times. It says drone strikes in Pakistan have killed many civilians, studies say. Far more civilians have been killed by U.S. drone strikes in Pakistan tribal areas than U.S. counterterrorism officials have acknowledged. A new study by human rights researcher at Stanford University and New York University contends. The report, quote, Living Under Drones, also concludes that the classified CIA program has turned the Pakistan public against U.S. policy in a volatile region. Real people are suffering real harm, but are largely ignored in government or news media discussions of drone attacks, said James Cavallaro of Stanford, one of the study's authors. Cavallaro said the study was intended to challenge official accounts of the drones as precise instruments of high-tech warfare with few adverse consequences. The study concludes that only about 2% of drone casualties are top militant leaders. The study said, but it cites estimates of the Bureau of Investigative Journalism, which has reported extensively on drone strikes of 474 to 884 civilian deaths since 2004, including 176 children. In April, Obama's top counterterrorism advisor, John Brennan, described civilian casualties from drone strikes as exceedingly rare, end quote. The study challenged officials' official versions of three attacks between 2009 and 2011, including a drone strike on March 17, 2011, that killed an estimated 42 people. My point is that our drones are killing innocent children in other countries, and they're not covering that in the mainstream media. They're not sharing that information. I'm not bringing this up to discount or to look down on the events that took place in Connecticut. I'm not mentioning that because that's sad. That touched my heart. And if you're a man with a beating heart and have living blood pumping through your veins, and on top of that you're a father and that Connecticut shooting didn't touch you, then something's wrong with you. Maybe you're MK Ultra, because that was horrible news to hear. That was horrible news. When I first got the full account, because I got some emails in the morning, said there was a mass shooting at an elementary school. I didn't get the full details till maybe like a couple of hours later. And I'll never forget, I was listening to Jim Rome. And he was just going on one of his normal rants when I'm thinking, he's like, I could talk about the LA Lakers. I could talk about this. I could talk about that, but why should I, you know? And he, when he said at the time, he said there were 25 people dead and all of them were kids. And this is what Jim Rome said at that time. I literally, like, as I was driving, just grabbed my face. Was like, oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. That hit home. That's hard. That's hard. Cause I have kids. You know, and then to watch the president's statement, you know, very emotional, President Obama, to me, it showed a man, a father, speaking to our country. And somebody brought to my attention yesterday, they was like, you know, I watched the Obama, his response. He said one or two things, either that was tears of guilt because he knew that that was going to happen or knew that that was going to take place, or just emotion of that sad situation. Friday night, comedian Paul Mooney was on TV, and it was so crazy because one of the things that he said in his stand-up comedy routine, for those that aren't familiar who Paul Mooney is, Paul Mooney is the man behind Richard Pryor, the late great comedian Richard Pryor. He wrote for Richard Pryor and a host of other comedians, the Dave Chappelle Show and so on and so forth. But nonetheless, one of the things that Paul Mooney, he's very controversial in things that he says in his stand-up routine, but he speaks a lot of truth. One of the things Paul Mooney said in his stand-up, he said, you know, this racism stuff, he said, we need to put it aside. He said, we need to come together. All of that racism stuff, he said, is they want us to create racial divide. He said, those people, those government, he said, they are out to get us. And what Paul Mooney said, I'm quoting him, not myself. Paul Mooney said, we need a revolution. He said, we need a revolution every 4 years. He said, we need to go up in the White House and start chopping off heads. He said, we need to go up in the White House and start chopping off heads. And he said, then they'll start paying attention. He said, but all this racial divide, they don't want us to come together. He said, we need to come together and do have a revolution. And he said, after the war, then we can get back to racism. You know? But there was a lot of truth to what Paul Mooney said. And he also mentioned the fact that you look at Russia, what happened with the Soviet Union, and how there was a revolution, revolutionary change that took place to where it is today, now known as Russia. At the time, it was the Soviet Union. And he said it started from within. They had a revolution. They protested, and there was change that was implemented. And that's what's going to have to take place here in America. Look, true change begins from within. And especially if you apply that to an individual, individuals, true change comes from within. You have to start with yourself. If your marriage is not working, start with yourself. If your job situation isn't working, start with yourself. True change begins from within. And it doesn't matter if it begins in the household, within your community, within your county, within your city, within your state, within a nation. True change begins from within. And I was on the phone with Sean from the Bronx, and he also mentioned that, you know, it starts at the local level, as far as the councilmen, the city councilmen, and the local officials, the delegates and stuff like that. These people are in our reach. And if we want true change, it starts from within. And there's so many distractions for Americans that it's sad, and we're being made fun of and mocked in other countries because of how dumbed down America is in popular culture and mainstream media. You know, there's a dumbing down of society. We're distracted by our favorite reality shows. We're distracted by football and NFL and NBA. And look, granted, I like watching certain shows, and I like the NFL. I like watching football. Don't get me wrong. I enjoy certain things. However, I have a level of balance, I would like to think. I have a level of balance. But many people aren't like that. Many because they aren't privy to certain information. And if people really truly knew what's taking place right now, there would be a significant outcry, and it would be a significant coming together, and it would take place. And just to look, you know, these chemicals and stuff that they're inducing in these people to create these Manchurian candidates. You also look at the stuff that they're spraying in our skies. It is documented. You look at, you know, the murder rate in Chicago is extremely high. It's been a war there for the past couple of years. And one thing Dick Gregory said on my show, you know, you look at what's being sprayed over certain cities, the manganese and some other chemicals that are being sprayed that's causing people to react a certain way. When you have drugs and chemicals, it causes the body and the mind an altered state. And it is documented, and I posted this on flowofwisdom.com months ago, that it came out in St. Louis that the government, the military, was spraying certain chemicals over urban neighborhoods doing a test. And I think one of the chemicals was like sulfate or something like that. But it's look it up. It's on flowofwisdom.com. It's one of the posts that I did several months ago. I mean, this stuff is real, and we need to be aware, and we need to start asking questions. And more importantly, we need to come together. You know, this racial divide is for the birds right now, man. It's for the birds. So just some food for thought. I see I got a couple of new callers. Yo, welcome to Flow of Wisdom. Hello.
What's up, Sean? It's Sean. What's going on?
Hey, what's up, man? I got about 90 seconds. Go ahead, man.
Yeah, you know, you hit the nail on the head. You know, it's sad what happened Friday, but there's a lot of things that people need to take into account and just ask certain questions without being insensitive to the situation. You know, a lot of things that are out there, MK Ultra, LSD drugs, you know, the fact that the stories are reported that the mom actually got the weapons. It just asks you, why does a school teacher need these kind of weapons? That just leads to more questions. And a lot of the call in the next week or two is going to be for gun control, but you can't control mental illness. You got to keep pulling back the layers, not just the guns. Because in China Friday, someone went into a school and stabbed 22 students. So what, do we need mic control now? You know what I mean?
Yep.
So peel back the layers. Don't just stop the gun control.
Absolutely, man. Sean from the Bronx. Thanks, homie, man. Yeah, Sean, and I didn't even get to that. He's right. In China, man goes into a school and stabs 22 kids. Look, the agenda is set now. They're coming after our Second Amendment. They're going to take our guns. And to me, look, it's not a gun problem. We don't have a gun problem, y'all. Because imagine if you take the guns, if you disarm law-abiding citizens, guess who still has the freaking guns? You. The criminals still have the guns. It doesn't make sense. I ran out of time, man. We'll do this again next week. Live life, get wisdom, and let it flow. Peace. Get motivated. Get motivated. Get motivated.